Good morning, students. Today we are going to do our third part of fourth chapter, that is change and development in rural society. Students, we are resuming our chapter from page number 64 of your NCERT books, 4.4, transformations in rural society after independence. Ample of transformations were done after the independence period, especially in agriculture and in those areas which were underwent by the Green Revolution. The biggest transformation was done in the field of agricultural labor, as cultivation became more intensive and people were demanding laborers for more and more agricultural work. And the second thing was the free wage laborers. Now, free wage laborers are the people who are free from the burden of zamindari pratha and bounded labor. They are working for the daily basis. Nowadays, how laborers are working. And they work for only those people, those cultivators who bid for their higher wage. After free wage labor, farmers who were belonging from more developed regions were just looking for the market. They were just thinking to sell their agricultural product. And this thing was also booming up the economy as well. As the farmers were focusing more to the market, this was initiating the money to flow into the village. This means that money was coming into the villages, and because of that money, there was ample of development into the villages, and that development was giving ample of opportunities for business and employment to the people, especially to the rural people. The commercialization of the agriculture was started at the time of colonial period, because Britishers were the one who initiated for the commercialization of the agriculture. Because of the modern technologies being used into the agriculture, it was helping to grow the economy of the villages. And these modern methods were also promoted by the government as well. In 19th century, a large land in Maharashtra were given over to cotton cultivation, and the cotton farmer became direct . The state invested in the development of rural infrastructure such as irrigation facilities, road, electricity, provision of agricultural input, and including credit through banks and cooperatives. The recently launched Deen Dayal Upadhyaya Gram Jyoti Yojana is an effort of the Indian government in this direction. This is a scheme which is designed to provide continuous power supply to rural India. Alteration in rural society was also happened by the medium or large farmers who adopted the new technologies, and this made the areas have a rapid agricultural development. In several agricultural rich areas such as coastal Andhra Pradesh, West Uttar Pradesh, Central Gujarat and many others, well-to-do farmers were belonging to dominant class have started investing their money, agricultural money, into the other businesses. This process of diversification gave rise to new entrepreneur group that moved out of rural areas and grew towns into a great developed regions. New elite farmers or rural elites, it can be professionals, white collar, people who have started new businesses or getting good profit, have started sending their children to the schools, especially to the private schools. Few farmers who had old lands, they collected all their lands, and instead of agriculture, they invested that land into some business and called themselves as entrepreneurs. As there was an immense development in Indian rural areas, and Indian government was also aiding the rural people, but few rural areas in India were still under sufferance. And this is because of the old tradition, or maybe because of the superstitions of the people. There were no proper facilities to the rural people. As the Zamindari Pratha was still prevailing there, and there was no calculation of the land under the Land Reform Act, there was huge fluctuation between the political matters in these areas. Areas like Eastern UP and Bihar were not getting all those facilities which they demand to. Because of the political constraint or because of the regional constraint, people were not getting all those facilities which were given by the government for the agricultural process. Due to a great geographical feature, Kerala was on the side of development, and this was because of the linkage with the Gulf countries, which have brought a large transformation in rural societies. Here, substantial means something in large amount, value, either giving importance to something. And Gulf countries are, it's Bahrain, Kuwait, Iraq, Oman, Qatar, Saudi Arabia, United Arab Emirates. Rural Kerala had mixed economy, as they have involved themselves with agriculture and with retail sales and services. And many number of families were dependent upon the remittances from abroad. Remittances means money, and they were dependent from the money from the abroad, as they were dealing with the abroad. Another topic is on page number 67 of your NCERT books, 4.5, Circulation of Labour. Another significant change in rural society that is linked to commercialization of agriculture has been the growth of migrant agricultural labour. As traditional bond of patronage between labourers or tenants and landlords broke down, this means that a person who gives money, a person who pays money, that was a bondage, that was some kind of burden for the workers, that broke down as laborers shifted to the free wage labor, that is daily earning labor. In green revolution regions such as the Punjab, a pattern of seasonal migration emerged in which thousands of workers circulated between their home villages and more prosperous areas where there is more demand for the labor and high wages. This means that people from rural area collected in those areas which were prosperous with green revolution regions, especially in Punjab. And some migrations was because of some inequalities or superstitions in rural areas. As an Indian tradition, men usually migrate or get out of their places or homes to work for their families, and women at their homes, at their husband's home, usually take care of his parents. Many of the worker belongs to some drought-prone places. Drought-prone places means a place where is inadequacy of water, dry land kind of place. So these people usually belong from drought-prone places or some kind of places which are less productive. And they usually go to work in the fields of Punjab and Haryana. Or sometimes they work in kilns of UP where bricks are made. And sometimes in the construction sites of New Delhi or Bangalore. There's a term footloose labor which is coined by J. Breeman. And this means a person who work on daily wages and is in search of a job on daily basis. And this term was applicable on all the migrants which are mentioned above. These landless workers do not have much rights, as they usually not paid well, or sometimes they have to work on very less wage. And wealthy farmers often prefer to employ these migrant workers for harvesting and other such intensive operations rather than the local working class, because migrants are more easily exploited and can be paid at lower wages. This is a strange pattern that in some areas, these landless laborers or landless farmers are moving out of their home villages in search of work during the peak agricultural seasons, and this migration and lack of job security have created poor working condition and living condition of these workers. The large-scale circulation of labor has had several effects on rural society. In poor areas, where male family members spend much of their time working outside of the village, now cultivation has become a female task. But there were ample of insecurity to the women as compared to men, as they earn lower wages than men for similar work.